Good afternoon, everybody. How you doing? So welcome back. This is the second visit of 13, and today we're going to talk about defined purpose. You got to have a defined purpose for the different portions of your life. Now, some people may just want to put this all in one bag and say that you got to have goals, but here's the thing about goals. See, I can have a goal. Like, I have a goal to make more money. I have a goal to be in better health. I have a goal to be a better father. I have a goal to be a better son, a better brother, a better husband. I have a goal to be a better friend. And that's a hard one right there. But I have these goals. I have goals to be a better student of my spirituality. I have those as goals, yes. But they're vague. See, the difference between a goal and a defined purpose is that a defined purpose, you have actionable steps that you're willing to take, but also you have things you're willing to give in order to get there. See, that having something that you're willing to give to get there, it forces you to take the steps, and then it forces you every day to do something towards that goal. Let me give you an example. So I'm the owner of Tiffany's Popcorn Cafe. When I decided in October of 2011 that I was going to open up a gourmet popcorn shop, I started writing out, what am I willing to do? What am I willing to give in order to open this store? I started figuring out, how much money am I willing to invest to open this store? And then even when I decided to join Visalis, I had to decide, how much time am I willing to give in order to make it a success? How much money am I willing to invest to make it a success? See, people don't necessarily think about those kinds of things. And what's funny about those two, I have people consistently ask me about franchising or how much it costs to open up a store. And when I tell them that it can cost you anywhere from $30,000 to $50,000 to $70,000 or more to open up a store, sometimes they buck. Oh. And these same people, if they ask me about Visalis and I tell them that it cost them $499 of an investment for them to start that one, oh. Look, most of y'all will waste $4.99 every month, if not every other month. You're wasting that amount of money. And if you look at yourself over the course of a few years, you might be wasting tens of thousands of dollars on things that really didn't matter, but yet you could have channeled that into opening a business, something that's going to give you back returns. Side note. One of the reasons the rich keep getting richer, people like to think that is because they're cheating. No. One of the reasons why the rich keep getting richer is because the rich buy assets. And those assets return more assets, return funds so they can buy more assets. The poor, they buy liabilities. The middle class, they just buy larger liabilities. Liabilities take money out of your pocket, whereas assets put money back in your pocket. If you own a house, but you're living in it, to the mortgage company, your house is an asset. To you, the house is a liability. Now, if you own a house and you're renting the house, then both to the mortgage company it's an asset, and to you it's an asset because it's bringing you a return. To the people who are renting, it's a liability. You understand what I'm saying there? All right? So when you're looking, when you have a goal, a defined purpose of, I want to make more money or I want to start a business, if you're not willing to invest your money, if you're not willing to invest your time, then you just got a wish. You just got a I hope that something happens. It doesn't work that way, all right? Anything worth having, you're gonna have to put in way before you take out. And then the thing about it is whatever you put in, when it returns to you, you gotta put it back in and just keep regenerating, keep letting it roll and roll. You know, I'm a Marine, so when my money is like Marines, so I send those Marines out. I expect them to capture some other Marines and then bring them back, and we can train them Marines up and send them back out to go capture some more. The same thing works in your relationships. You gotta put into your relationship more than what you expect to get back. But here's the beauty of all of it. Here's the beauty of all of it. Whatever you give, it will return to you 7, 8, 10-fold. But you gotta give it though. So, you know, you gotta have a defined purpose in order to get there. And you gotta know what you wanna give And here's the other thing. You got to set standards for yourself. What's the standard of work? The standard of execution? What's the standard of return that you're going to expect for this? Because when you have a defined purpose, you have an expectation of getting back a certain level of return, of getting back a certain lifestyle, of getting back a certain emotional responses. You have certain expectations, and you got to hold those expectations up to the standard that you originally set for yourself. But if you don't set a standard, then you will just get whatever comes back to you, and you will accept it, whether it's good or bad. You will accept it as a failure, or you will accept it as a success, or what often happens, you accept it as the average, mediocrity. So look, guys, have a defined purpose. So tonight, I want you to sit down. Today, sit down and just define out what it is that you want in your relationships, in your finances, in your lifestyle, in your health. Give it a defined purpose of what it is that you want. Then write down a list of everything you're willing to give in order to get there. Time, talent, money. What are you willing to give? All right? And then actionable steps, how you're going to give it. Actionable steps, how you're going to give it. And then the standard of your expected return. The standard of your expected return. So have a great day. I'm happy for you, energized for you. Blue energy all day, baby.